Good afternoon, Namaskar, Salam and Adab to everyone present here. Honorable guest on the dais, Professor Manoj Kumar Jha, Member of Parliament, Janab Dr. Sayyid Jafar Mahmood Sahab, ex-bureaucrat and President, Jakat Foundation of India, Janab Saaf Faisal, topper of 2010 IAS batch, M.W. Ansari Sahab, ex-DGP Chhattisgarh, Shri Ajay Jain, publisher of this book, other dignitaries, august audience, academic fraternity of Delhi, friends from media, my several friends from the state of Maharashtra, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you all to the auspicious and august occasion of release of my book, Denial and Deprivation, Indian Muslims after the Sachar Committee and Jagannath Mishra Commission reports. Dear friends, I wanted to say something about the book, something outside the book in detail, but since our chief guest, Professor Manoj Kumar Jha, has to attend the next function at 6:30, so I will cut short my presentation and give a brief detail about the book. Dear friends, the book which is coming before you, a 550-page book, result of 3 years of continuous writing and 1.5 years of intense editing by the publisher. I would like to inform that the Sachar Committee report was submitted to the government in 2006, and Jagannath Mishra Commission report was submitted to the government in May 2007. After publication of these two reports, several community organizations, NGOs, community activists, RTI activists, committed individuals, etc., have been making tireless effort to fathom the level of denial and deprivation within the community. However, there was no clear picture on the national level. Worsening condition, marginalization of Muslims, and pathetic state of implementation of policies compelled me to think deeply, and this proved to be an initial inspiration and encouragement to write this book. The book attempts to gauge and analyze the level of denial and deprivation faced by the Indian Muslims so far by presenting their correct situation after 12 years of these two reports. It presents and discusses the current conditions with respect to outcome indicators such as population, education, economy, poverty, unemployment, availability of bank loans, infrastructure and civic facilities, and representation in government employment. By placing facts in perspective, the book also discusses Urdu, madrasa, and the condition of waqfs in the country. Responses of various political formations on these reports have been presented in a proper sequence to generate a coherent view to facilitate implementation on the ground. In the post-Sachar era, government has started many schemes to improve the condition whose reach and impact is assessed with the help of latest data. It presents the social structure of Muslims, presence of OBCs and Dalits, and suggest a practical pattern for Muslim reservation. It follows up the process of implementation of recommendations of these two reports and highlights how the government adopted tokenism, attempted to implement minor recommendations and shied away from their major recommendations. It presents the lopsided attitude of the UPA government, hostile attitude of the present government, and accelerated marginalization of Muslims in today's scenario. Lastly, a roadmap on what needs to be done at all levels, state, community, and individual has been emphatically suggested in the light of the deprivation, marginalization, and intellectual observations in the country. My effort is to create a perception where Muslims' problems could be treated as national problems. The book emphasizes the need to take concrete steps for inclusive growth and mainstreaming. The book is based on government reports, various reports presented in the parliament and state assemblies, reports published by some organizations and NGOs, newspaper reports, reports on internet, articles written by scholars, experts, and at the same time, information collected through RTI. The book concludes the condition of Indian Muslims on various outcome indicators. A brief summary I would like to give before you. Muslims population as per 2001 census is 17.22 crore, which is 14.2% of the national population. Although the decadal growth was high, its fertility rate is fast declining compared to other religious groups. Literacy rate is almost 68.5, which is well below the national average. Although enrollment rate is high, the dropout rate is also high, which is affecting the higher educational attainment in the community. Current data show that the Muslim representation has not improved in Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, in IITs, in IIMs, and other premier institutions of the country. Economic participation is very poor. Access to banks and bank credit is very poor. Inclusive banking in the country is still a distant dream. There is an inverse relation between the presence of infrastructure facilities in a locality and the population in that area. Muslims are slightly less poor compared to SCs and STs in rural areas, but they are the most poor in urban areas. Their participation in government employment has not improved after the two reports. They are less represented in UPSC, Army, Police, Judiciary, State employment. Their participation is well below than their share in the population, and there is no government effort to improve the situation. Loot of works property is still going on. There is no government effort to check it, although community intellectuals have suggested many things. There is no effort to bifurcate the OBC category and put the Muslim OBC in the most backward category. Sir, your subject. No progress on scheduled caste status to be given to Muslim Dalits and Christian Dalits. In the wake of Sachar committee report, the UPO government had started some schemes for uplifting the community. The government response can be termed as half-hearted, as provision of budget and sincerity as demanded from the official did not match the level of deprivation in the community. The follow-up action of the Sachar committee recommendations suggests that a small and unimportant recommendations were touched, while the major policy issues such as National Data Bank, Equal Opportunity Commission, Diversity Index, Delimitation Commission to de-reserve Muslim populated constituencies have not been touched so far. In the present scenario, a difficult situation has come for Muslims. I will explain it in two, three lines. In the present scenario, it appears to be a consensus among all parties to not address concerns of Muslims. Even media, scholars, political commentators do not show any interest to highlight the development deficit of Muslims and the alienation they face today. The situation is going from bad to worse, and experts say that if the same situation persists, the Muslims will become the neo-Dalits of Indian society. Sir, in 2014 May, we heard Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas. In the parliament we heard, even the third generation of Muslim brothers whom I have seen since my young days are contending with their cycle repair job. Nobody can be called healthy if one of the organ is disabled. On 25 December 2016 in Kozhikode, we heard 50 years ago Deen Dayal Upadhyay ji said Muslims should not be treated as different people. Do not reward them, do not rebuke them, but empower them. They should not be looked down, nor should be treated as substance for votes, but consider them as your own. But what did we receive in reality, sir? We got mob lynching, communal riots, killing and violence in the name of cow protection, slogans of go to Pakistan, demonization of Muslim through manufactured terms like love jihad, triple talaq, rampant discrimination in all sectors of employment, closure of minority schemes, anti-Muslim stand on many prominent issues. The end result is schemes of Muslim progress have stopped yielding any result. They are not development subject now. As we saw in the post-Sachar era, concerns of safety and security have taken over the issues of socio-economic empowerment today. Speaking at the Hindustan Times Leadership Summit on 1st December 2017, Mr. Barack Obama, then ex-US President, said that when he was US President, he had told PM Modi in person that India must not be split on sectarian lines. He suggested that India must cherish the fact that Muslims in the country clearly identify themselves as true Indians. Mahatma Gandhi said, a civilization can be judged by the way it treats its minorities. The United Nations Declaration on Minorities says, in any state, the faith and confidence of the minorities in the functioning of the state is an impartial manner, is an acid test of its being a just state. The book concludes that India cannot progress in real sense if 15% of the population is left behind. Without their participation, India cannot achieve development it deserves, and at the same time, India cannot become a superpower by leaving behind its 14.2% population. I dedicate the book to hundreds of community organizations. Sir, after these two reports, there is a lot of hue and cry. Lot of NGOs, organization, activists are working on the ground to get the reports implemented. So I dedicate the books to them. I dedicate the book to hundreds of community organizations, NGOs, activists, and committed and spirited individuals who genuinely and tirelessly are involved in larger effort of empowerment of Muslims. I close with great hope and expectation that the intended readers and the people in the government would read the book and provide valuable help in their capacity to improve the overall condition of Muslims. I close with comforting thought that it would help in reducing disparity in Indian society and at the same time mainstreaming the Muslims in greater effort of nation building. Sir, this is my effort to highlight the pathetic condition of Muslims through a book before you, before the audience. Now the book is coming before every citizen of the country. Now they have to judge what is the level of deprivation, denial in the community, and what should be done, because Muslims are original inhabitants of this country. And by depriving them, by denying their genuine rights, India cannot progress at all. We are born here, we will perish here, and till last, we will be Indian. Aap yahan pe jitne log aaye hain, sabka main shukriya ada karta hoon. Aap is book ke release ka गवाह बन रहे हैं, इसका मैं शुक्रिया अदा करता हूं. मेरे जो गेस्ट हैं, काफ़ी दूर दूर से आए, साफ फैसल आज ही कश्मीर से आए, जफर महमूद साहब ने अपने व्यस्त समय से वक्त निकाला, प्रोफेसर मनोज झा भी काफ़ी व्यस्त हैं, उनको नेक्स्ट प्रोग्राम अटेंड करना है, बाकी हमारे गेस्ट ऑगस्ट ऑडियंस, आपको भी बहुत सारे व्यस्त समय से वक्त निकाल करके यहाँ पर आना पड़ा. आप इस बुक रिलीज़ का विटनेस बने, इसलिए मैं सबका शुक्रिया अदा करता हूं और अपने दो शब्द खत्म करता हूं. धन्यवाद. जय हिंद.
थैंक यू मिस्टर रहमान फॉर योर थॉट प्रोवोकिंग स्पीच. आई वुड नाउ रिक्वेस्ट प्रोफेसर मनोज झा टू डू द ऑनर ऑफ रिलीजिंग द बुक, एंड अदर गेस्ट्स ऑन द डायस आर आल्सो इनवाइटेड टू रिलीज द बुक.